Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss. And you're probably wondering what AI tools I've used to make this pretty interesting introduction. Let me show you how I've done it. Well, first and foremost, Replicate announced some new things recently, including restyling of a frame of your video via Flux context and applying the style to a whole video using Luma. So let's do that. First, here's the Flux context model. Doesn't the demo look really good? So we're simply going to replace that video with something different. That will be the intro that you've just seen to this video. And there it is, added as my input. Now we can choose which frame to apply the change to, and we'll choose the first frame. And then prompt, well, let's leave it as make it and may, because that's so in right now. We'll leave everything else the same and click run with our Replicate account and let it produce the result. And there we go. Oh my goodness me. That is me as an anime character. So this is the first part of the puzzle that I need. And all I need to do is click on that and make sure to download it. Now I'm going to go to a quick Amazon S3 bucket and throw those up into the cloud. With that done, I can now use the Luma Modify Video model, and for the video URL, I'll put the URL to my intro bit, and then the first frame will be that anime we just created. Again, we'll keep the prompt as make it anime, and we can choose the model. Now it here is going to be close to the original video, Flex is in between, and Reimagine will use AI creativity. So I'll go in the middle and click run. Now this can take 2 or 3 minutes, so we'll skip forward and look at the result. Now you can actually see over here in the output, it is dreaming and working away on our new creation. And it's completed. There it is. Oh my goodness me. Isn't that crazy? That is anime me generated in just a couple of minutes using some fantastic AI tools. So there you go. Flux context mixed with Luma Modify Video, and you've got a dream team for making different styled videos on demand. And the best thing is Replicate has an API, so you can hook it up to all your workflows and automations and do this kind of stuff for your social media. I'll link all the tools you need in the description down below.
Next up, and a post on X from Elon Musk suggests that Groq 4 and Kimi K2 are competing for top of the trending models charts, according to OpenRouter. Well, last week we tested Groq 4. I thought this week let's try Kimi K2, but take it a step further and use Groq. No, not that Groq, the other Groq with a Q that is super lightning fast. I'll just go ahead and create an API key here for RuCode. And over here in VS Studio, I can set up RuCode to use my API for Groq. This is the place to input the key. And now I've got the chance to choose a model. I will choose Moonshot AI's Kimi K2 and give it a test. Create me a really cool game based on the dinosaur game that appears in the Chrome browser when you're not connected to the internet. But this time it should be about lightning bolts and you should be lightning fast to avoid them. And you'll see that this is working away at lightning speed to complete my request. It's already made the to-do list, and it's making API requests and also telling me how much I'll be charged for everything that's going to happen. I'll auto-approve now, and let's watch at the speed of light how fast this runs. And now you'll see this video is not sped up, and it's actually going through and writing the code for me really this fast. I'm not going to speed up anything here. I'm just going to let Groq work away, make this game, and run through the whole to-do list, and we'll see how far we get. Right now, it's on to implementing the CSS styling for the lightning theme, and it's making a request and getting the code complete. And now it looks like everything is completed here for my lightning runner, so let's run it and see how it looks. Now we've got a browser window open, let's click this, and look, this is the game that Kimi K2 created in just moments using Groq. Okay, and look at this, here's my game, it's actually working. Wow, I've got to dodge things and collect spinning orbs, and oh, I bashed into the wall. And what's more, if we actually take a look at the costs that RuCode has totted up for us, it costs just 16 cents to make this game with API calls to Groq and Kimi K2. In my opinion, that's definitely a win for free and open source. Finally this week, OpenAI released ChatGPT Agent. It is an agent that takes action on the web for you, like booking trips to New York City, just as in this example here, accessing the Expedia website. It can also run code in a box, of course, analyze your business metrics, and connect to your apps like Gmail, where it can look through all your recent emails and summarize your inbox for the day. It could go over to Google Calendar and check out your schedule and confirm your availability. Plus, it can make slideshows and spreadsheets with ease. So whether you're giving that next business presentation, speaking on stage, or you simply need to crunch together a bunch of numbers, OpenAI have got the solution for you with ChatGPT Agent. I look forward to getting hold of it myself so I can show it to you on this channel.
So there you go. AI gets crazier and crazier by the week, and I really hope you enjoy these updates as much as I enjoy bringing them to you. Let me know what you thought in the comments down below, and as always, throw a like and a subscription would very much be appreciated, and we continue the conversation in my community. So go ahead, find the link to join up down below if you haven't done so already, and YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.